Hello everyone, it's nice to see you back for another retro video. Today we are going to look at the benchmarks for the stock settings of the ASRock 4CoreDual Serial 8082 with the Pentium 4 4200 MHz. That's the 540 model. And we start with the BIOS that looks just like the regular AMI type generally used by ASUS. In the advanced section, we can see the most important options. In the CPU section, we will disable the hyperthread in order to have a fair fight. The chipset offers some RAM options, and we are going to set these to 2.5 to 2 values that we are used to. The lower part of the menu offers some AGP options. It's better to have the aperture set to more than 64 as it created some problems in the past. And there are some PCI Express options. The rest of the options are pretty self-explanatory. I will disable the devices that are not going to be used. Also, the rest of the menus are pretty usual, as you can see. Let's start with the info. The CPU is running 0.2 GHz, but it's a Prescott on 19 nanometers, just like the AMD Athlon 64 we had in the previous episode. The original socket 478 Pentium 4 had 130 nanometer lithography. Also, there are some SSE-free instructions present. The RAM runs on 2.5-to-2 configuration and has a command rate of 1. Off to PC Mark, and here's the score. Then there's Sandra. CPU bench is particularly interesting. Also, cache mem is interesting, as we can see the improvements Intel has brought to the new processor. Next, there are the graphics tests, and we're gonna start with the usual 3D Mark 2001, followed by Aqua Mark 3. In this video, we will be introducing the Aquanox, or the AquaMark 2, and we're gonna let it run a full test. Now let's run the demos in the quick free game. As you can see, the game is limited by the maximum frame rate. In order to fix this, we need to go to Nvidia's driver in the performance and quality settings and look for the vertical sync and force it off always. For older drivers, you can do this with the CoolBits registry patch. And we are going back to Quake 3. After all this Far Cry benchmark runs, one thing has caught my eye. Although the game doesn't allow it, the benchmark can be ran with OpenGL, so we are going to do that next. We are also going to have a full run for this, as we need to inspect the game and the graphics to make sure that everything is okay. And it's obvious by the water and vegetation problems why the Far Cry team hasn't included the OpenGL option in the settings. If you look around, you can enable the OpenGL option for the game in the hope you can get a better frame rate, as I got here with a slower video card. And next we move to the games. And this episode will be dedicated to OpenGL. And we're gonna start with a Quake Free Engine game, Return to Castle Wolfenstein. This game doesn't even allow for a direct 3D option. If somebody knows a way, please leave it in the comments. Next, we move over to Far Cry, and we're gonna have a trial run with Direct3D. And now we will try the same run with OpenGL settings. As you can see, because of the higher frame rate, even my aim is better. On average, we got 10 frames per second more in OpenGL. In the end, it looks like the Pentium 4, although adding the SSE-free instructions, wasn't that much of an improvement over the regular Pentium 4 from the socket 478. There are some results that are higher than expected in CPU Bench 2003 for the CPU, but other than that, almost everything was on par with the original 3.2 Pentium 4. For the graphs, overclocking, and conclusion, stay tuned for our next video. Until next time, bye and have a nice day.